let's face it, we're all a little bit perverted. We would all rather undress old people with our eyes at bus stops than read a book. I have personally compiled a top 10 list of greatest video game perverts. Let's start off. Number 10. It's Tingo from The Legend of Zelda games. Tingle Tingle Kulo. Wait. What's with the tight lycra, the crotch bulge, the outer underpants and constant prancing? In the end, this guy is perfectly harmless, just a tad misunderstood. At number 9 we have Winston, better known as Lara's butler, from the Tomb Raider series. Easily recognizable from his shuffling gait, this incessant stalker won't leave Lara alone. He never leaves the Croft mansion, and always follows after Lara shaking the cutlery. You can even hit the poor guy with a quad bike and he still serves a warm beverage. Get back in the freezer, you creepy old dude. Number 8 is one of my favorite game perverts. It's Brock, from the Pokemon games. He fancies himself as a bit of a ladies' man, though he is always rejected. The mere mention of skirt leaves him as rock solid as the Pokemon he trains at the gym. I wonder what hindered his eyesight. Larry Laffer is at our number 7 spot. Yep, that's right. This sleazeball. Middle-aged, balding, unemployed. He's the most joyless pervert of them all. The king of loserdom, he trudges from one woman to the next, hopelessly seeking to exchange bodily fluid.
Yeah, like that's ever gonna happen.
At number 6 we've got a female pervert, Katsuragi from the Senran Kagura series. When she's not fighting, she's sexually harassing, groping and molesting her way through high school. I never had a childhood, but I assume it's not supposed to be like that. Number 5 is Duke Nukem. The all-American perv. Shoot some aliens, shoot a hooker, it's all the same to this chauvinist. Shake it, baby? What a douche. Number 4. Now we're getting real pervy. It's General Vulgan from Metal Gear Solid. All stand to attention, or he'll probably grope your balls. I mean, is there anything he doesn't want to have sex with? A power-hungry, sadomasochistic military leader with megalomaniacal tendencies. Not to mention the full-body rubber outfit he's concealing under that officer's jacket. Number 3 is the Don of Perverts, Don Corneo, from Final Fantasy VII. Owner of a sleazy mansion, frequenter of the local brothel, he keeps a torture rack in the basement. He lines up prospective girls in his throne room and throws the unwanted ones to his underlings. And he struggles to tell the difference between men and women, but it hardly matters to him. It was hard not to put this guy at number 1. Voldo, from the Soul Calibur series. In essence, he's an S&M gimp with knives for fingers and a gait that's half snake, half crab. Still, with a penchant for fishnets, leather in clown shoes, no one can accuse him of not making an effort. And number 1 is? Ryuus Clover, from Blaze Blue. The pervert extraordinaire. Child murderer, mad scientist, torturer, he's a pretty twisted guy. Can you get any more perverted than making puppets from the bodies of family members? Probably not. Unless you are the proud owner of some kind of rape dungeon. Which he is. Wear your crown proudly, Ryuus, for you are, in essence, everything wrong with the world. Remember to like this video, tell your friends to subscribe and look out for the next installment, Top 10 Video Game Locations to Hide a Stuffed Dog.